हसना मसूदी जी, फिर दोबारा मैं कहना चाहता हूं कि
सर
3 minutes
we
have around more than 12
no, this should 14. Start this kind of direction should start from first time when this comments
it never happens you know that
in midway
it never happens it always
thank you sir sir
as such we have extended
sir,
the time till 8 o'clock
the high court and the supreme court judges salaries and conditions of service amendment bill 2021
has come up after a day we joined nation in paying tribute to Baba Saheb Ambedkar, father of Indian Constitution. It was Baba Saheb Ambedkar who on 17th, it was under his guidance that on 17th October 1949, special status was granted to the Jammu and Kashmir. And this house on 7th August 1952 approved Delhi Agreement of 1952. So, and this house on 5th August 2019, ignoring, it was the decision on 17th October 1949 was without a whisper of disagreement, without any dissent, without any amendment, without any resignations. It was unanimous. This is only one aspect of the case. And on 5th August, unmindful of the basic tenets of the Constitution, the spirit of the Constitution, with the ambit and scope of Article 3, and the ambit and spirit and sweep of 356, that the state was denuded of its special status. But, sir, when we speak about Constitution, as, sir, you are aware, it has letter, it is letter of the Constitution. Then there is spirit of the Constitution. Then there is morality of the Constitution. We are eminent lawyers here. And there's ethics of the Constitution. Unmindful of constitutional ethics, spirit of the Constitution, and morality of the Constitution, the constitutionally suspect law is being implemented. See, the principle is that whatever is under consideration, judicial scrutiny under consideration has been formally admitted and referred to a constitutional bench should not be implemented. Because we will be, by doing that, we will be, by acting in that manner, we will be preempting the judgment that may come of the Supreme Court. So it is unfortunate and it is very sad that a judgment, the constitutionally suspect law is being implemented. Now coming to the bill. Sir, honorable members have voiced concern about alarming, monstrous pendency before the courts. And they had, rightly they have voiced concern that, and they have repeated that justice delayed is justice denied and there should be expeditious justice. But I want to remind the House that whatever is pending before the courts, that is not the only pendency. There is the pendency that has never seen the door of the court. Because most of the people live with the grievance. They live with the insult that is heaped on them. Live with the injury to which they are subjected because they don't have enough resources to go to the court of law. Because they don't have access to justice. And access to justice is integral part of right to justice under Article 21. We are eminent lawyers here. So, we have to ask a couple of questions to ourselves. What is the part of GDP that is spent on the judiciary? We say it is one of the three limbs of the democratic setup, a democratic polity. But what is the amount, what is the percentage of GDP? And my information, it is not more than 0.7%. Unless we increase the number of judges, the number of courts, how do we expect the system to deal with the alarming pendency that is right now, awaiting disposal for last so many years and it's in some cases decades. First is the manpower. Where is the trained manpower? Because I have seen it from a closer, I have given a closer look, I have been part of the system. How can you deal with the pendency unless you empower the system? Until you provide sufficient resources to the system so that the system can gear up and meet the challenge. That is not being done. Second is, as has been pointed out by learned members, honorable members, that second is the vacancies. But who will fill up vacancies? Unless we make vacancy filling up system an efficient mechanism, keep benchmarks, keep time frame everywhere, we will not be able to fill up the vacancies. See, the effort must be to empower the judiciary, to strengthen the judiciary, to provide sufficient resources, sufficient manpower, sufficient modern day gadgets, networking system, see, internet facilities everywhere across the country, then only we will expect the judiciary to come up and to roll up its socks and meet the challenge.
Thank you.
Second is, sir.
This is the third.
We will come to this. And second is the expectations. Mr. Suresh said that.
Please wind up now.
Mr. Suresh said that some segments do not get representation. I will speak about Kashmir. No elevation to Supreme Court from Kashmir. We are from Jammu, but not a single during last 75 years from Kashmir. We don't have a judge. But that apart, so coming to the bill, I think bill is only explains the ambiguity, tries to clear the ambiguity. But I think baseline is that you should make judicial service attractive so that you can attract talent. We know whatever is the salary of a judge, maybe it is one appearance in fee in Supreme Court. How can we attract talent unless and until we revise the salaries and give attractive terms? In this case, there was an ambiguity, no doubt, but I am in agreement with, respectful agreement with Mr. Pinaki Mishra, that the it was better to, out of respect, go ahead with whatever was held by the two high courts, and indirectly also there was the seal of approval by the Supreme Court, and go ahead with this. What are the financial implications? You don't get it on completion of 79th year. You don't get it when you step into 80th year. You get it when you are in 81st year. How does it matter? What are the implications? How much money you are going to lose? But you would make the service more attractive. Talent would feel attracted to the service. So unless and until you do that, unless you make the service conditions much better, you cannot attract the talent.
Thank you, Masoodi ji. Thank you very much.